am going through chlorine right and left. So I asked my friend Mark from Doheny's to come in and help me figure out how I can be a little bit more conservative with my chlorine use. Mark, is there anything I can do to conserve chlorine?
Beyond actually making sure that your water chemistry is in balance all the time, so we're not using too much chlorine, you know, for bad reasons. We wanna make sure that we're shocking the pool once a week, because that adds more chlorine to the water, so your chlorine can work more efficiently with a chlorine-based shock. And then I also suggest shocking your water once a week with a non-chlorine-based shock.
Okay, Mark, what is the difference between chlorine and shock?
When we say the term shock, what we're really referring to is superchlorination. So essentially what we're doing is we're taking a lot of chlorine and putting it into the water at once. It's kind of a catch-all. That's why we tell you to do it once a week, because we know you test the water every day, right? And sometimes we forget, especially during the summertime when activity is highest, et cetera. So we just make sure that we know if we're shocking once a week, we're putting a ton of chlorine into the water or shocking the water, so we know we're killing everything.
Okay, how does that work?
It's an oxidizing shock. It's an oxidizing agent. That goes into the water. It's non-chlorine based, and it's really designed to oxidize the pool water or essentially burn out dead or spent chlorine cells, which we call chloramines. Essentially, chlorine goes into the water and it does what it's supposed to do. It fights and kills bacteria and virus, et cetera, but it can only do so much. And once it dies, it's spent. And it just kind of floats around the water until it either gets splashed out or it gets filtered out. And one thing we can help those chlorine levels with is that when we burn off those dead chlorine cells by oxidizing them, we're allowing all the new chlorine cells that are being introduced to work more effectively and efficiently. And yes, it will cut down the amount of chlorine that you need because we're doing that on a weekly basis.
So if I'm shocking once a week, how often should I use that?
I would use it once a week as well.
Do I do it at the same time?
I would do them on two different days just because you don't want to have a chemical reaction. So the great thing about this is you can swim after 15 minutes. Pour it in the water, let it do its job, and the kids can be swimming in 15 minutes.
What's another reason why someone might want to use oxidizing shock?
Well, I love it for that reason, but I also love it because it's almost like a water polisher. It will give you that dancing diamonds look on the surface of your water, which is great.
Is there something that will tell me if I'm using too much or too little chlorine?
It can happen, I guess, but your best gauge is just a test. If you're between 1 and 3 parts per million, you know you're there. If you're too high, just let it disperse. If you're too low, you need to shock the pool and add more chlorine.
Thank you so much, Mark.
You're welcome.
I hope that was as helpful for you as it was for me. Make sure that you visit doheny.com for more articles, videos, and everything you need for your pool. Oh, and free shipping.